Hello there, my fellow miners and crafters. Good times with Scar here, and welcome back to the wonderful worlds of Hermits and Crafting. And we're flying over the top of our brand new minigame. We're in our last episode. We built out the island and, of course, split it into mycelium and grass with a giant red line down the center. And in today's episode, we finish this game and prepare it to play. And that is going to be a lot of work. We're going to build a massive tree for the grass team and a massive mushroom for the mycelium team. And we need to set up the home bases, the places where the source blocks live inside of the caves. We need to get somebody like Mumbo or somebody to help us with the redstone here so that we have special doors that require feats of strength to open. And all sorts of other really cool things to make this not just a little paintball arena, but something a little bit more special. Now, I have been doing quite a bit of work off camera in the lower regions of the game, and boy, I can never recommend what you're about to see. And that is, well, a drained out portion. What in the world? Why is there a water slide over here? I don't know why there's a water slide. It must have been another creeper went off. But anyway, this area was once underwater, and yeah, it was quite a feat to drain this all out. But in the process, I learned something very satisfying. And that is the fact that sponges dry out now in the Nether. And while I was draining out that area, I did it all wrong. I must have spent 6 hours doing it, probably the worst possible way you could imagine. So when I looked it up, I found this method of drying sponges super quickly. And best of all, you can incorporate your, oh, here it is, the super hoe into it, and you can just blast it all out. Look at that. Oh man, this is a lifesaver. Today's episode is going to be a daunting one, a mega project at that, to finish this entire game. We're going to need to pop back to the Nether and enjoy the sizzle of some of those sponges while we're working on this project. And the first things we need to do on our checklist is to build up the bases, the ginormous mushroom and the amazing tree on this side to represent both teams. Then we need to do the caves where the source blocks are going to be contained, along with the doors that the other team are going to need to break through to get to their source blocks. Inside this cave over here is where the home bases are, and that'll be the grass team over here where they'll start the game with their beds, armor, and crossbows. And of course, on this side, the same thing, where the mushroom team will get their equipment. So we need to build a whole lot of... Oh man, what was the chances of falling through that hole? Oh, as I said, we're gonna have to build up a whole lot of crossbows and rockets that are capable of one-shotting people with a whole lot of particles. So yeah, our PvP slash capture the flag slash tower defense game is gonna be quite a challenge, but I think we've got this. If we don't, we can just watch some sizzling sponges in the Nether. So I was gathering some resources for our project and had a bit of inspiration strike here at the town hall to decorate it for Christmas. That's right. How amazing would that be to decorate this with garland and snow and maybe even a tree? That would just be so much fun. So we're going to get to that eventually. And I think good old Gargru or Baby Yoda here would absolutely love to see this entire thing transformed into a wintry wonderland. Wouldn't it be? The diamond trees packed with snow? That would be amazing. It will be very nice once this war's over to clean this area up and build, finally, after all these months, my official storage room. If you have any tips on cool storage rooms or ideas, let me know. And now an entire box of logs with a smidgen extra, but we're probably going to need at least two more of these boxes for enough logs for the big tree. And the bone meal grind never ends here at the backside of the magical village. And boy, this takes a long time. Setting up some form of cactus farm or something in the future would make this a whole lot easier. And now, with a bit of chopping, we have enough mushrooms to create our massive mushrooms. What in the world? Where'd you come from? Is that? Oh my gosh, that's a ugly Christmas sweater. That's a mycelium. Let's show him Baby Yoda while he's here, because Greed and I talk about Baby Yoda after every episode for hours on end. And you get Baby Yoda back. Give Baby Yoda back. Don't become Moff Gideon. Don't do it. Don't become Moff Gideon. Moff Gideon. No, this is the way to the dark side, Gideon. We've spoke about this. No. Oh no. Wait, okay. The arrows was a totally bad idea. He just pulled away from us. Oh shoot. Oh crud. Wait, my son, he must be... No, what is he doing? He's doing a trench run now. Oh my gosh, where'd he go? Oh, there he is. Okay, the glint is our saving grace on that one. The armor glint of 1.16 is very powerful. And why am I not... Oh, no, apparently Kelp denies rocket launches. Oh shoot, oh, that's not good. Oh crud, where'd he go? Oh no, where do you go? Oh, this is so bad. Oh no, who turned out the lights? Oh, Baby Yoda, where did you go? Oh, not good. Not good at all. He's taking Baby Yoda. Oh, Gargru, I'm so sorry. Oh, this is so bad. I feel like I'm about to land on a Gungan underwater palace here. This is not good at all. Oh, our new goal today is to get poor Baby Yoda back. And that is our goal. Return Baby Yoda and build out this game, which I have found these shiny blue shulker boxes awaiting us here, which I think I know what they are. In the Hermitcraft meeting, I asked if anyone had quick shot or multi-shot enchantments for villagers, and Etho's like, I do. And I'm like, oh, can you help me? And he's like, sure. And I'm like, sweet. So I think this might be, yes, oh my gosh, I could hug that beautiful, beautiful Etho. This is amazing. Well, look who has returned. You better not be mocking me. I'm gonna get, oh, come on, dang it. We've got Stormtrooper aim. So with that, it's time to start building our first base here. Let's start with the mushroom because, well, I have the best ideas for that one so far. So my friends, let's hit super fast build mode and build up some super amazing mushrooms. Super fast build mode, and we've got our massive red mushroom built up and ready to go, looking extra super fancy. And across the way, Bdubs has come over and helped us do the team grass side, which I am so grateful and appreciative, and a very dangerous tree at that, apparently. What the heck? How did I die? Well, as I was saying, I'm very grateful and appreciative of Bdubs helping me get the tree and this side done so that I can meet the deadlines, as I have been falling very far behind in that because I'm not really great with schedules and time management. Also, Mumbo has come over and done the redstone for the game, which is absolutely fantastic. And I'm also very grateful and appreciative of Mumbo. And we'll meet up with him soon to go over all these little redstone bits and bobs. But for my side over here, we've got the mushroom built up and ready to go, looking fairly good. Like, I'm pretty happy with it. I love the darker interior with some of the edrons poking out, the detail in the trunk. There's a lot of different blocks mixed into it. And as for these other pillars here, those are going to be for the other mushrooms. I got a really fantastic design for some brown mushrooms, which might be my favorite mushroom in the end once we get these all designed. And yeah, I just logged on today to start working on my mushrooms. Didn't know all of this was going to happen overnight, which is amazing. As I saw, Bdubs had just started working on the tree and bam, you wake up in the morning and this happens. It's like Santa Claus arrived. So let's finish up our area, get all those mushrooms installed, and then we start working on the starting houses for each team. Get the crossbows, armor, and rig everything all up. So let's hit super fast build mode one more time. Super fast build mode, and we've got the big and now the medium mushrooms built up and ready to go, and I am absolutely loving them sitting up on the cliff here. And the interior of the brown mushrooms might be my favorite thing of the mushrooms, and I spent quite a bit of time trying to design the interiors because you will be looking up into the mushrooms, so you want to make sure they look nice from below. And I think they came out really fantastic. And of course the big mushroom with the crimson and the end rods looking down on you, and I forgot to do that in the interior of this mushroom, so I will work that out. But I'm very curious to know, which one do you like? Do you like the brown mushroom or the red mushroom more? And in the interiors here, I have started to spruce them up. I still don't know how to get inside other than going through the emergency entrance here. And this area is starting to get worked out. So this, of course, was where the source block is going to go. And speaking of that, we are about to meet up with Mumbo in just a moment to go over all the redstone, because I am very confused at how all of this works, other than the fact that, hold on, where's the other entrance down? Here it is. There's some weird cockamamie ways into different places, but this is very dangerous down here. I've had to go, hold on, let me get some more torches here. I've had to go through here and actually light this up because I am terrified that this beautiful, beautiful redstone is gonna get blown up. Man, I think Mumbo might be worse at lighting up builds than me. Hello, Mumbo.
Hello, that was a very, very elegant entrance right there. That was impressive.
Was it a 10 out of 10 land?
I would say so. That was very smooth. That's Ooh. Far smoother than anything that I do with an elytra, that's for sure.
Ooh, why, thank you. I have something for you. It's a present.
Okay. What are these?
Dude, your redstone down below is a death trap. Oh. I killed multiple creepers just chilling on your red ropes down there. I was scared.
It is a bit of a problem. I mean, I must admit, okay, I have been caught by one of the creepers that has dropped down from your unlit areas around here. So I guess we're both as bad as each other.
I am known for my lighting up builds. Mm-hmm. Everyone knows this. But dude, yeah. I logged on, and first of all, there's major treeage appears. And then
serious trees.
And then I start tripping on this carpet, and I'm like, oh my gosh, Mumbo's been here. And then I'm like, doors. Multiple doors. Mumbo definitely was here.
Yeah, so I've been busy. It looks like also you have been incredibly busy in the time that I have kind of stopped doing redstone stuff. You have just come in and just built these insane looking mushrooms. I mean, this looks very different from when I was last here. So this is also quite impressive. There's clearly been some progress made.
Oh yeah, I'm mushroomed out at this point from building these things.
Well, okay, I'll quickly give you a tour and I'll quickly like show you what I've done redstone wise and mm-hmm. then I can kind of get your approval. So first things first, I've got these vault doors at the end here. We've got one on each side, and the way that you open them is you both have to press buttons at the same time. So we might have to try and coordinate this.
Okay, okay.
So if you go over to the other button, which I think is over here, or I'll go over there, and then you can...
Or we could just go through the back, but this seems more fun. Yeah, I made an emergency entrance.
All right, so I'm going to count us in. Should we press on one, or do we press on press? What do you reckon?
Let's do one.
Okay, three, two, one. You didn't go on one. I thought
I did go on one.
Let's go. I said let's go on one. So that means you go on when one is.
Oh, I thought you said like press. Three, two, I'm sorry. Okay. All right, we'll go on one.
Okay,
one.
Ready?
Okay, yeah.
3, 2, 1.
Dude, oh, it worked.
Okay, well, we're just about.
Oh,
there's no button on the other. There's no button on the other side.
Oh no, it's okay. I made the emergency exit. Remember?
Yeah, it's a good thing that you actually made that, because otherwise I'd need to find another person to hit the button to get you out.
Oh gosh. Oh, so that works. That's exactly how we envisioned it. That is really cool.
Yeah, that's
cool.
Perfect. I will need to put a button on the inside so that people can actually get out of the vault, because otherwise that's a bit of a design flaw. Okay, so next up, I have some defense systems as well. So what I thought we could do is if we hit the defend button,
oh, wow, right
on this side, okay, mm-hmm, you can see these barricades pop up. So that will stop people from being hit by the firework rockets and things. But also behind the barricades, I've also got these dispensers. So as those barricades pop up, I'm hoping that potions, like the lingering potions, should mm-hmm pop up behind these, and they'll be like buffs. So you can stand behind, get defended from, you know, behind this wall, and also get buffed up. So then you can pop out and start killing people. So that's if the other team is like looking like they're going to attack. But then wow, if they are attacking and they're like in your side, mm-hmm, then you can hit the attack button, and that will activate all of the dispensers that are underneath this carpet that currently do nothing, but you can see these little water things.
Yeah.
Basically, TNT will be dispensed here and it will explode, but it won't destroy anything because it's in water.
Oh,
and
wow,
that will create like a lot of explosions through here. So that would be quite dangerous.
Oh, wow. That is, you just blew my mind. I'm just blown away. That is
so
really
be
cool.
It's gonna be quite a powerful attack, and I'm hoping to also add a few more attacks in the walls as well that will activate when you hit that attack button. So it will be quite chaotic. Like there will be fire and there'll be TNT explosions, and then yeah, when people are trying to defend, there'll be lingering potions and things. But I've still got a few bits to do. Like I need to do the wind detection, so we need to detect when the source blocks get transferred over. I think
yeah,
that's pretty important. And also just like little details and bits and pieces. But no, it's been so much fun. I've been really, really enjoying this. I've been fully geeking out. So
dude, you
cool.
Blow my mind with this. This is really cool. The thing that I need to do maybe like in this area is make maybe another cave, and then
yeah,
put the beds
yeah
and the dispensers and stuff for the rockets. And then, oh, I actually got to make the rockets. I got to do that later. I'm going to see if anyone's on. I'm going to test the rockets on.
yeah. Well, we've got, yeah, there's still like a few, like I need to collect so much TNT. So obviously each one of these dispensers needs to be filled with TNT. So I've got to do all that and collect a bunch of potions. So there's still like a little bit of resource gathering left to do, but I'm hoping that I should be able to get all of that done tomorrow and get everything kind of ready to rock and roll. So hopefully it should be operational, and then we can make some tweaks, you know, later down the line if things aren't going well. But I know that we've got deadlines, like serious deadlines.
Oh, so many. But dude, this literally is almost a fully operational game, which is
yeah,
amazing.
It's almost there. Yeah, this is
oh,
great.
Yeah. And I can help get some TNT. There's a shop over there. It has this like industrial pass thing, and there's like unlimited gunpowder.
Yeah.
It's pretty amazing. So I will definitely help you get some of those.
Sweet.
Yeah, and yeah, I need to work on some. Man, dude, the biggest thing that's missing in my stuff is I need little plants. Like, you're working on this cool redstone, and I'm like, man, what's a mushroom bush look like?
I mean, that's a difficult question. This is why I stick with the technical stuff and all the logical things that are just totally unsubjective. They either work or they don't. There's no kind of standing back and going, is that correct?
Is like, a mushroom bush worth doing?
I mean, I'm not even qualified to answer that question, Scar. I hate to say it.
Well, dude, thank you so much for putting all this redstone together. It is looking amazing. Well, I basically just created my worst nightmare. This area is truly a mushroom wonderland of horrors. And yeah, so this is the title of this video, basically. Scar creates his worst nightmare. It definitely also gives off a vibe of Candyland. Now I kind of want to play Candyland. Bringing back some childhood memories. Anyway, you might be wondering what the deal is with all of this end rod spam here. And that is creating kind of little mushroom pockets, right? You know, when these little kind of sprouts pop up, they're, you know, very dense in nature and they act as good lighting sources. Because originally I had a lot of carpets down with this color being very vibrant. It kind of took away from it and made it even more kind of Candylandy. So kind of breaking that up with the end rods, I think, help quite a bit. So here are the low-lying plants that we talked about. I wasn't sure what I was going to do with it. I think these look pretty cool. They definitely feel a little alien-like, a little mushroom-like, and I think that is looking absolutely fantastic. And this somewhat solves our lighting issue. We still need to sort out the lighting issues on the main platform. So I think that is something we will deal with once Bdubs and Mumbo are all wrapped up with their sides. Now, you might see there is a hole over there, and there, well, you can't see it, but trust me, there's a hole on that other side, and those are going to be the team bases. That's where you pick up your crossbows, your ammunition, and your respawn, things along those lines in your beds. So now, well, we gotta sort this out. We got our very first crossbow, and I'm quite excited about this. We haven't had a crossbow set up like this since season 6, where we had our Lagomatic. So I'm pretty hyped about this. So I'm going to make six multi-shot and 6 non-multi-shot, and I'm gonna test both of them in play tests of the game to see which one works better and things like that. So I got a lot of enchanting to do. Mumbo's industrial district looks really cool from above, but we stopped here after paying for our pass and picked up 3 shulker boxes of gunpowder and 3 shulker boxes of sugarcane, and I feel like this is worth way more than 10 diamonds. We might go give him a couple more diamonds because that's valuable, right? So yeah. Oh, wait, I didn't know he had bones. Oh, we're definitely paying him more. We're going to need some of these too for the particles for the fireworks. And another 10 diamonds, Mumbo. I was going to give you 20, but I'm starting to become a little poor. This is going to be one of the greatest grinds that we have ever done. So it is gunpowder and then just fill the rest of the crafting bench up and bam. And hopefully we can start filling up our inventory with these firework stars and figuring out if we're going to do a multi-shot or a single shot. Hopefully we can get somebody over here in a moment to test this on, but I'm going to be the first guinea pig, and this is going to be amazing. All right, so we're going to take off all of our armor, and I'm just going to shoot the floor and see what happens. Oh, that's good. That's really good. That's good. I'm glad we went down to like 2 hearts. So that gives somebody just enough chance to maybe get away, maybe replenish, but then you pop another rocket. So let's add another one to the arsenal here, and I want to experiment a little bit more, see about adding some color and maybe making it a little bit more powerful. Oh, this is gonna be amazing. How cool is this build? Like, come on, we got the big mushroom, we got the big tree, and all of these incredible details here. Now let's pop into the cave, and as you can see, we're just getting it sorted out here. So we got the beds, we got the team armor all set up and ready to go. Now, once Mumbo is all wrapped up with the redstone, I'm gonna come through here and add more obstacles in the ground so that each team can't see the other emerging from their cave. Like, this is a really good setup where I want to improve the mycelium side. And then of course this is the grass team, and man, this has been a lot of fun. We faced our fears and we made my worst nightmare. That's the mushroom area, and I think in the end this area came out pretty darn cool, and I cannot wait for you guys to see this game come to life. Oh, that was so much color in my face. It felt like Christmas. Wait, one more time. Look at that. It is. It's Christmas. Oh, I love it. Oh my gosh, that is fantastic. I just really want to push these buttons in here, but I can't. I'm a little bit loopy right now, as it is 2 in the morning and I'm still putting around at this game. But yeah, guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoy and are as excited as I am for this brand new game. So until next time, this has been Good Times with Scar, and I always really appreciate you guys taking the time to watch videos. If you believe the video deserved a rating, that would be much appreciated. Until next time, we'll see you later, and don't subscribe because you may just become scarred for life.